In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that is using the Bollinger Bands for a signal and the Stochastic Oscillator as a filter, so let's see how we can do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on a little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. You need to give it a name. I have given it the name Standalone Bollinger Stochastic.mq5. And the first thing that we want to do is to import the trade.mqh file. That is part of MQL5 and it helps us to do simplified trading operations. Afterwards, we need to create an instance for the class Ctrade. This is called Trade in our case. And now we import two external modules. The first one is called Check Entry Bollinger Bands, that is for the signal. And the second one is Check Entry underscore Stochastic, that is the module for the filter. I'm using these modules here. We have already coded them in another video, and they are part of the robot trading system and the platin system. In the next step, we are going to calculate the ask price and the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double for the current symbol on the chart, either for symbol ask or for symbol bid. And with normalize double and underscore digits, we make sure to automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. Now that we have done that, we use MQL rates to create an array for price data that will be called priceinfo. Now let's continue with the Ontick function. We start by using array set as series for the priceinfo array to sort the array from the current candle downwards. And then we can use copy rates for the current symbol and the currently selected period on the chart, starting from candle 0, that's the current candle, and we want to store the prices for 3 candles in our price info array. The current price can be calculated by looking at the close price for candle 0 in the price info array. Actually, this expression here is not really a close price, but it's the current price. It will become a close price as soon as candle 0 becomes candle 1. So now to get the trading signal, we check the check entry Bollinger module. To get the trading signal, we call the function called check entry Bollinger. This is inside of the check entry Bollinger bands module, where we basically create a signal, declare a few variables for the three bands of the Bollinger band. Then we use array set as series to sort all three bands from the current candle downwards. Here we use IBands for the current symbol and the currently selected period. For the last 20 candles, the shift value is 0 and the deviation value is 2. And those values are the standard values for the Bollinger bands. And the result should be calculated based on the close price. These three lines here fill our arrays for the middle, the upper, and the lower band with data for three candles. And that makes it possible to calculate the current value for candle 0. And we also do that for candle 1. And if the current close price for candle 1 is below the lower band value for candle 1, and the close price for candle 0 is above the lower band value, that would be a buy signal. In the other case, if the close price for candle 1 is bigger than the upper band value and the close price for candle 0 is below the upper band value for candle 0, that would be a sell price, and that's when we would assign the word sell to our signal. Finally, we return the signal to our main module. Now that we have calculated the trading signal, we want to do the same for the trading filter. That is done by using check entry stochastic. That is this module here. Here we do the same. We first declare a variable for the signal and two arrays for the K and the D array. Then we use array set as series to sort the arrays from the current candle downwards. And afterwards we use the iStochastic function that comes with MQL5 for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. These are the standard values for the stochastic. You can look them up when you drag the stochastic oscillator on your chart. We use mode SMA, that stands for simple moving average. And this one, STO underscore low high, is shown in the MQL5 reference. Basically, it means we calculate based on the high and low prices. Afterwards, we use copy buffer to fill our K array and our D array for 3 candles each. Then we calculate the current value for candle 0 for the K array and the D array, and repeat that for candle 1. And if the K value for the current candle is below 20 and the D value for the current candle is also below 20, we want to check if the K value for candle 0 is above the D value for candle 0. And we also want to know if the K value for candle 1 was below the D value for candle 1. If all those conditions apply, we want to buy and assign the word buy to our signal. In the other case, if the K value 0 and the D value 0 are above 80, we want to check if the K value 0 is below the D value of 0, and if the K value 1 was above the D value for candle 1. If all these conditions are true, that would be a sell signal, so we assign the word sell to our signal. And finally, we use the return statement to return our signal to the main module. And here we continue to check if the trading signal equals buy and if the filter equals buy. And the third condition would be that we have no open positions, and that is true when positions total returns the value 0. If this expression is true, we use trade.buy to buy 10 microlot. In the other case, if the trading signal equals sell and if the filter equals sell, we want to check if we have no open positions. And if this expression is true, we use trade.sell to sell 10 microlot. Finally, we use command to output the Bollinger signal and the filter for the stochastic oscillator on the chart. And if you are done with all these modules, you can enable the toolbar and click on compile, or you press F7 on your keyboard. You shouldn't get any errors here, and if that is the case, you can click the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And inside of MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file that we have created. It is called Standalone Bollinger Stochastic. Enable the visible mode here and start your test. And now you should see some signals on your chart. And as soon as the trading signal and the filter see the same signal, we should see the first trade. I will speed up this a little bit, and yes, the first trade was placed. This once again was a video that was requested by a premium course member. And if you are a premium course member and have an idea for a video like this one, please let me know. In the other case, you can find the premium course and even the starter course for just $1 on our website. That will help you to create standalone expert advisors like this one. So far, so good. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.